Hi, and welcome back. It's been a long time since I uploaded a new episode. I'm just not fully recovered from COVID, and I have school and my new job, so it's been a while. But now we are going to continue on this Piaggio MP3. I want to be ready before the weather is becoming good. Spring is coming, so it will be a nice time to ride it again. Today we are going to take out the carb and we're going to clean it. So let's put some work clothes on and continue. So here we have the carb we are going to remove. We undo these two screws so we can take it out. We can take out of disconnect the automatic choke and the fuel line or fuel cable. So let's continue. I take here of a Phillips screwdriver. We undo this. Then we take a flat screwdriver for this side. And now we can undo the screw on the side here. Let's see, it's a Torx, but maybe I can. Disconnect it like this. This one is this. We can take it down when it's come off. Just take a clamp to undo the fuel line. It's always better that you put it from down below, because when you take your plier and you pull it, the hose of the this will tighten, so it is difficult to remove it. When you put a flat screwdriver under it and push it up, it's better, then it slides off. Let's see what we must remove more. The only thing I believe is the throttle cable. So, now the carb is out, we are going to take it inside the workshop to disassemble it, and then we can clean it. And I will show you more about this carb. It is very filthy, I already see. If you can look inside here, the butterfly, it is all dirty. But I will clean it up. I got an ultrasonic cleaner, so that's why I can clean it up. So, we are now on our workbench. What we're going to do, we're going to disassemble this and we're going to put it in here in our ultrasonic cleaner. I just bought it on AliExpress You can also find it on Amazon and that kinds of channels. It is not very expensive, but it's very handy. You can clean your car, your tools, all other kind of stuff, jewelry, your glasses. You can all clean it in this piece of equipment. It is very handy. I've got some Tikpur Air 33, specially for carb cleaning. So now we're going to disassemble everything and we're going to clean it. Make sure your workbench is clean. It's better for your carburetor and no dirt coming inside. If you can see here, it is all dirty. This must move up and down. It is a little bit stuck. That's why the fuel was pouring in inside the cylinder. And it makes overflow it. So we are going to disassemble it and just clean it. If you see here, let's show you on camera. This one is very dirty. The butterfly valve. Let's see how it is after cleaning. But first, we are going to disconnect it. What I like to do is put the screws back on the original spot, so I don't lose them. These screws are very tight. What I do, I give a little push down and then I rotate it so I don't damage the screw. This one is very stuck. Sometimes it won't come off. The former owner claims that he already done the ultrasonic cleaning, but I don't believe it when I see it. So it is good that we will do this. So this screw won't come off. I don't think it is a problem. I think the ultrasonic cleaner will clean it inside and it's for the choke. Let's try to clean it with this on. So I will continue to put the rest from it. So let's start on the bottom. Here I have the basket where I can put the materials in that I want to clean. And this basket is going in there. There was always a few screws that won't come off. Why? So this screw is too damaged to take off. So what I will do, I will take my multi-tool. I make here a straight line in it that I can do with a flat screwdriver. I can take it off. I try to take it off. So let's continue. So this will not come off, but I got a new screw. It's the same size. So what I will do, I will take out this, drill it out and see it from there. So now it's come off, and let's try to remove the rest of the screw. Oh, I can do it by hand. So here I have the new screw. And if you can see it, it's a perfect fit, so it won't be a problem. So if you can see, it's very filthy inside. There are a lot of old fuel, but we will clean this off. No, I won't take this off. We will take out this main jet. If you can see, this is really open. I can see through it. Let's focus. No. So this will be not a problem. Now this is all clogged up, so this is dirty. We cannot see through it. That's why the fuel is not good in here. But we will clean it. So now let's take off the top. Just blow the air away. The debris. Don't forget to put back the screws. when you undo the last screw, just hold it, because under here is a spring, and when you not hold it, it will spring up and you will lose some stuff from inside. And now just if you can see the membrane here is broken, so that is what we must replace. This is the fuel needle. It's a little bit dirty here on the top, but it will clean off. A little bit of dirt here. This is just on the edge, so I don't think it will be a problem for now, but I will replace it in the future. If you can see here, it's old, dirty. But we will try to clean it off. I don't think it will fit once. I must do it in multiple times in here. Don't forget to put back the screws. So now just fill this up with some water. I put in here some hot water, because the machine, it takes a long time before it is warmed up. Yeah, I must do this in two times, because one time is not, it's not fully recured on the water. Now let's put some R33 in it. Because this is a content of 3 liters, and I must put in 5%, so I must put in here 200 mils of liquid. So I will set the time on 30 minutes. So now let's turn on the machine and let's see what he will do. I set it here on 75 degrees. The water temp is only 55. And this is the time. If you can see here, it will clean off now everything. So now let's wait 30 minutes, then turn the carb around for the other side, and we will continue. Thank you. So one side is done now. Let's turn it the carb around to do the other side. Don't forget to put some gloves on, because the chemicals is not so good for your skin. So now let's clean the other side. And we will put it on. And just start it. So, see you when it's done. So now it's done, also on the other side. What we now will do, we take this out and clean it in clear water to get all the chemicals out, and then we can blow it off with some compressed air. So now let's go to the bucket. And just clean it off. So now we have done all the cleaning, and we have rinsed down with some clean water. It's time to blow all the water out. If you can see, the valve here, it's not much cleaner. So just blow out all the water, and then we can put it back together. So, if you can see, it cleans out very well. Now it's time to put back everything back together. I just checked here the gasket. It's nowhere broken, it's all still good. So I don't have to replace it. So, let's put back everything together. Don't forget to put the nozzle back. If you can see, the floater is moving freely, so that's a good sign. Some of the screws were just falling out because of the ultrasonic. But I got all the screws again. So now you just hear a snap. That is when you put it back correctly. I just screw it in slightly. I will do the final at the end. But now, for now, it's just that it's holding on. and the flathead screw, the new one, because we must drill out the other one. But this will do just fine. And now I will screw it securely. So this side is done. Let's do the other side. So put a little bit closer. This can only slide on one manner in this. This you can take out also. It was falling out while cleaning. When I put it the wrong way, you see, it will not slide in. Just slide it in correctly, and then you see it slides freely. Just put in the needle, and then we put in the spring. Make sure your gasket here is good. It sits right. You see here a little notch. You put it on the over the spring. And now you must hold it down. Try not to manipulate it or move it too much here, because then you can damage the gasket. This is only on the edge. It will seal off now, but I will replace this in the future. I must order it. So when it's come in, I will put a new one in. It's better for the carb. But I can do that when it is on the motorcycle. Just line up the holes. And we can screw it in. Just tighten slightly. The final I will put it on the end. I put much string to it. So if you can see, it slides freely now. And we can mount back everything else. Here we have a line from the factory. We must make sure that lines up. And then can we secure it. And the last thing, final last thing, in here you have a little filter. This one is still good. You can change it. Never ride it without this filter. So this is how you clean and disassemble again your carburetor. So now let's put it back on the motorcycle, and then we will continue. So you have here two lines, this one and this one. You connect it here on this piece. It's for your coolant, for your engine. What I do, I put them up so it won't leak. I think it is a stupid design from Piaggio. Why put it there? It's difficult to get it on and off. But you don't want to lose too much coolant from your system. But I will check it on later when I ready with the motorcycle. It won't have a function. It is difficult to get it on. So what I have done, I removed it. It's one screw. It only flows through here, nothing else. Maybe it is for heat transfer, I don't know. But I will put it on like this. And when it's not good, I will put it back. But for now, I just do it like this. I think I just leave it like this. I don't see any problem with it. So, now we do all the mounting back, everything. And we work from the opposite direction what we did earlier. The electrical connections, I can put it in when it is secured again. So, this is all the time that I have today for this episode. In the next episode, I will change out the spark plug, the fuel filter, the oil filter. I put new oil in it and all that kind of stuff. Then I will start it because now everything is dirty. The spark plug is not good. The oil is not good because there is a lot of gasoline, of fuel in the oil. So I will change it out, I will flush it, and then we will start it again. But for now, thank you for watching. If you like this channel, put a thumbs up, please subscribe and put the post notifications on, so you don't miss out on anything. I hope you like this episode, and see you next time. Bye bye.